Hello viewers, today we will talk about a special device which is extensively used in manufacturing and automation.
Its purpose is to monitor crucial process parameters and to adjust process operations accordingly. It is specially designed to survive in harsh conditions and shielded from heat, cold, dust and moisture. They are called Programmable Logic Controllers or simply PLC.
These are some of the commonly available PLCs around the globe.
The components that make a PLC work can be divided into three core areas: the input-output modules, CPU, power supply and rack.
The input-output are the I/O modules. Information is passed in and out of PLC through these I/O modules. The input module has terminals into which electrical signals generated from sensors or transducers at the plant side are entered. The output module has terminals to which output signals are sent to activate solenoids, motors, heaters, displays, etc. Typically, there are 4, 8, 12 or 16 terminals per module. Sometimes, the processes controlled by the PLC are at long distances from the CPU. Electronic systems such as remote amplifier units are used to avoid loss of data.
The central processing unit, CPU, is the brain of the system. It carries out mathematical and logic operations.
Operating system is stored permanently in ROM area of CPU, and it is not lost when the input power is off. The application program is stored in the read-write portion of the memory. A battery backup may also be present to prevent the loss of data. The power supply and rack. The PLC CPU works at a constant voltage and current. Thus, PLC contains a built-in voltage converting power supply. There are two types of PLCs, the fixed and modular. A fixed PLC contains a fixed number of input and output. In modular PLC, input and output can be expanded.
The rack is the component that holds everything together. Modular PLCs have a chassis, also called a rack, into which modules are placed with different functions.
A PLC is event-driven. PLCs can be programmed in different ways, such as ladder logic, structured text, instruction list, functional block diagrams, and sequential function chart. We will be studying the ladder logic and instruction list for designing PLCs later in this series. A PLC operation is of three steps. Input scan. It checks the status at input side. Program scan. CPU starts executing the application program written in PLC programming language. And output scan. It writes the data into the output module so that all the outputs are updated. The scan time is how long it takes the PLC to loop around the whole process back to the start. When the PLC scan begins, it maps the memory matrix for input and output. A discrete input can be designated by I and discrete output by O. This again depends upon the PLC designer and manufacturer. The next number indicates byte followed by the bit. I 0.0 indicates the 0th byte and the 0th bit. I 0.1 indicates 0th byte and the 1st bit, and so on. We will discuss this in detail in the next few episodes.
A little history behind PLC.
Before PLCs were created, many industries such as the automobile industry used hundreds of thousands of relays to control their processes. This was very time consuming, less robust. Sometimes electricians would individually rewire every relay to change a production system. The development of low-cost computer has brought revolution in automation. The winning proposal came from Bedford Associates. The first PLC, model 084, was invented by Dick Molle, who is now considered the father of PLC. Ladder logic programming has been developed to mimic relay logic. It's relatively easy. To understand PLC ladder logic, we must first understand the relay logic. We will be covering it next time. We also have a playlist for digital electronics. Have a look at it and we will be back soon.
Hit the subscribe button and stay updated.
Stay calm and keep learning. Peace out.